So, apparently I heard that there is a Korean version of this being made that will be played by the actor who played Sang-woo, which is insane just how crazy this series has gotten, and I do expect to see many more remakes of this. But we have come to the end of the original, the Casa de Papel, otherwise known as Money Heist here, and it's insane, right? Like, as this is coming to an end, we hear that a Korean one is in the works now. And I think that this story can be told for any place, really, especially with inequality, money, all of that, which I won't get into here because we could have a long discussion about that. But this is our part two finale and the finale for the series as a whole. So, pretty much where we left off is where we start off here. As we know, Tokyo has died, and now the professor is in quite a pickle about what to do next, but nonetheless, they had a plan here. And so, what happens is a video gets released to the world explaining how he was able to scam the Royal Bank of Spain. And of course, people, when they find out that things can be so easily disrupted, get scared. And we see the financial markets take a tumble in a whirlwind as the stock market's crashing and the sky is falling. And so, this puts everything more into perspective of maybe the professor and the gang aren't the only ones in the corner, and it's in fact the government as a whole. So what ends up happening is that they have to figure out a way to get this whole crisis averted and get everything back on track before everybody starts losing their mind about where this gold actually is. And so what the professor does is he actually is like, yeah, if you pretty much let us go, you can pretty much get stability back. We'll have a ton of gold back and you can use it as a photo op, but in fact, it's actually just brass that has been painted to look like gold. But it doesn't matter because the people will see this as a form of stability, even though there is nothing that stabilizes the coin or the money or whatever. It's just all in their heads and an illusion. And I was like, if that ain't speaking the truth. But regardless of all of that, we see that they definitely do accept this, and then Tamayo and the rest are pretty much defeated, and we see our people, our gang, be saved once again. And so what we see is that they are now handed new passports and new lives. We see Denver and Stockholm reunited. And in the end, the professor celebrates and he asks Sierra what has happened to the gold. And it turns out that it's hidden in a house built by Tatiana and Rafael on its way to Portugal in the back of a truck. So that's pretty much where we end this whole series here. And so we pretty much end it with the group now living their life and free after pulling off the biggest monetary heist. And so that's pretty much where we end. And I think a lot of it here is more to do with the philosophy of money and control and power, where we saw that the Bank of Spain, whatever, doesn't even have the gold anymore. But it's just that illusion that there is no more things to panic because we have something that looks like gold here, but it's not really gold, and we all know this deep down inside, but we can still continue this illusion. So, at the end of the day, the gold might just be worthless, even when you think about it, because there really was no like backing it. It was just we said that this is what backs gold, and this is what backs gold. So, if you believe that gold backs your money, then your money is worth something again. Whereas, when there were gold was missing, people panicked because that meant their money wasn't backed by anything else and it was completely worthless. So I think that they did more than just pull off the biggest heist monetary wise, but they also started to open the eyes of the people and show them that what is really controlling you here? Is it the gold? Is it your money? Is it the government? All of that. And I think that's the thing that the professor wanted to show at the end. And I think at the end, they got two victories out of this. And now they're able to go live their lives however they need to. So I thought that that was a pretty crazy ending right there. But let me know what your thoughts are down below about the money heist and what do you want to see next. Do you believe in a sequel being made for this? And do you believe that this is the end? I know that Berlin is going to be having their own show pretty soon, which is interesting to me. So definitely excited to see how that plays out. And also, I am very interested in seeing what other country decides to adopt this into their own language. As we know, as I said at the beginning, the Korean version is coming out. I would be interested to see how that plays out, especially since if it's something along the lines of what I think, like, them trying to do it, like, based on their own country's inequality and all of that, I think this could be a show that could be adapted by many different countries, and I'd be excited to see each one. I think a different story in each and all of that. Don't play it out the same way, because I feel then it gets dragged out. But I'm interested, however, to see what they do. So let me know your thoughts and opinions down below on that. In the end, I think that we definitely got the biggest win from the professor on a philosophical level as well. But you let me know your thoughts and opinions down below on this show. Did it end on the right note? I feel like it definitely did what a lot of great shows do, where they don't try to go further into more seasons just because they know people will watch them. They try to end them at a sweet spot where it's like people would have wanted more, and you'll hear people that want more, but it's like this is the best spot to finish it off, right at the peak, and that way we stay at the peak. Maybe they could revisit it later down the road with a short film or something else, a special episode, whatever it may be. But for the most part, I think this is the best spot that they definitely picked to have this come to a definite conclusion. But I'd like to know your opinions. Did this ending live up to the hype of the show itself, or are we just pretty much done, like, oh, a disservice by ending it now? Let me know in the comments down below. I'd like to know your opinions. And how do you feel about the ending to this show? Was it everything you were expecting, or were you missing out on some stuff here? Let me know down below. Anyways, as always, that is gonna do it for me. If you haven't already subscribe to the channel, like, comment, share, all that good stuff. We are on the road to 20,000 subscribers. We are less than 50 away. Hopefully we can get there by the weekend. Make sure you check out my other videos as well if you haven't. I have a ton of shorts coming out as well. Just I think I'm going to do shorts on, like, quick movie stuff, and then if I want to talk about something more in depth, I will make a video like this, but just playing with ideas right now. Monday, we will start a podcast here, so definitely stay tuned for that if you haven't already, because we are going to be discussing a lot on those podcasts, and I think they'll be released every morning, so it definitely will be, like, the bigger news from the morning and maybe the night of and things like that. We don't have a name for it yet, but I think I have one in mind, so stay tuned for that. Anyways, as always, that's gonna do it for me. Make sure you hit that subscribe button, like, comment, share. Make sure you hit the notification bell, because YouTube likes to be a little funny about things, and I know they don't like to tell you when some videos drop or when they don't, so make sure you have that notification bell so you know when those videos all drop. As always, that is gonna do it for me. Check out the video on the left, and I'll see all of you next time. Stay safe, stay positive.